In this episode of Cyber Truth, I will talk about a very unpopular opinion: why hackers don't use Metasploit, or why Metasploit is not for hacking. What's up, guys? This is Irfan from ehacking.net. So, Metasploit, a compelling, well-organized, and a very famous framework in the ethical hackers community. But do hackers use it? In my opinion, no. But this is my opinion, and as I said, it is a very unpopular opinion. But I will discuss some facts that will support or help this opinion. All the cybersecurity community online discuss Metasploit. If you see a tutorial online on YouTube, or if you see any blog, you see Metasploit widely used. But this is the problem. All the training, tutorials, and the courses, whether it is online or offline, they discuss the pen testing, not the hacking. And I'm talking about hacking here, which people usually don't talk because it is against the policy. For example, Google's policy, the YouTube policy, and the Facebook policy. It is against their policy to publish a tutorial, like hacking tutorial, or to talk about any hacking tool or technique. Whenever I use the word hacking in this video, I'm talking about the well-organized cybercrime, specifically the APT, or Advanced Persistent Threat, that hack government organizations and stays undetected for a longer period of time. Please note that I'm not talking about the DDoS or online frauds here. I'm talking about the hacking that has or that have created an impact. If you search on Google about the most notorious, dangerous, or devastating hacking attacks, you will see many, but none of them initiated with the help of Metasploit. Let's see this one: Stuxnet, Shamon, malware, and many others. For example, the Sony hack and all these Ukrainian blackout, shadow brokers. None of this attack used any Metasploit component. Now let's talk about some series of attack, like the Titan Rain. Titan Rain is a well-coordinated attack, a war between China and the United States. The attacks were originated from China. And similar to this, we have many other attacks as well, but none of them used any Metasploit component. However, they used the exploits, but those exploits are also available online. And apart from this, the hackers community or the hackers usually write their own exploit code. There are platforms that analyze these attacks. For example, this one. So if you see the analysis, you will find a similarity or the similar characteristics. For example, there you can see, create an undetectable malware, bind it with the structure. So they basically create a malware and then they bind it with the exploit code and the payload. The malware establishes a reverse connection to the server. I'm not talking about the bind connection here. I'm talking about the reverse connection here to successfully bypass the security mechanism in the network. And once the reverse connection established between the malware or the payload to the server, which is commonly known as the C2 server or the command and control server, they usually target the victim, or they spread their malware using the phishing, or if they are doing a well-coordinated attack against a specific organization or purpose or person, not purpose, then they use their spear phishing. So they usually write their malware in different languages. They use various exploits, but the structure is more or less the same. But most of them, or I think all of them, don't use Metasploit, except for one or two. For example, this is the gzipd, if I'm not pronouncing incorrectly. Then this malware connects to the server. Yeah. So this is the characteristic. So this is the malware. So this malware connects to the server that has the Metasploit payload. So this is an example where they have used the Metasploit. There you can see. So it's the server. The C2, the command and control server, has the Metasploit payload. And apart from this example, I can give you another example, which is the Turla APT. So the Turla APT in their campaign, the Mosquito campaign, they used Metasploit as the first stage backdoor only. So just remember, at the first stage backdoor only and nothing else. So, you know, apart from all the given data, the Metasploit is not a hacking tool. As a Rapid7 team claims, the Metasploit both framework and the pro help in pen testing and testing the system's security. Even the OSCP by offensive security restricts Metasploit's usage in the training and the exam because of its automation. And there could be other disadvantage of the Metasploit as well, which I will discuss in some other video. Having said that, the Metasploit framework is fantastic. A main engine that contains so many exploits, payloads, and different code and techniques to accomplish so many tasks efficiently and in a single platform. It is useful, like very useful, when you are conducting a pen testing. But based on all the given information, we can say that the hackers don't use it. There could be the other reasons, like the companies usually patch the publicly listed vulnerabilities and their correspondent exploits that are usually available in the Metasploit, and hence they don't work. And apart from this, the AV antivirus programs can detect the Metasploit's payloads, and encoder does not work because the people they used to encode their payload and they used to upload it on the online virus antivirus engine, so that their signature, so the antivirus usually detect it. The hacker groups have their own encoders and the techniques to bypass the AV program or the AV system. There are many open source program or the encoders available, but they usually write their own. Anyway, so as I said that I've, you know, this is my opinion, but the Metasploit, like as I said, is a very strong framework, and I will make another video on this. I mean, how strong it is. But anyway, what do you think? Write your opinion in the comment box down below and let the whole world know about it. And if you like this video, then do share and do give me the thumbs up. Apart from this, I'm looking to know your opinion as well. So see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.